this last session, I'll wake up again, then we'll be free. So, I will present some basic web techniques in combination with Drupal. And the first question is, what do I have to do with Drupal? So, I'm a student at the Stuttgart Media University, and I did two Drupal projects. And the first project I did in direction of web development was working a JavaScript application calculating dances on ice. So you could choose like your program length and some starting category, which then generates some HTML, and you could choose jumps then and combinations and kind of delete them again, and it's following some rules. So these fields will be generated depending on what you choose up here and calculate some result. So what does this have to do with Drupal? Nothing actually. but the student I was working with, hi, he implemented that application in Drupal, and that's kind of how I got in touch with Drupal first. So a semester after that, I was thinking, if he can do this with Drupal, I can too. Can't be that difficult. So I will let some video play in the background. That's a page I implemented for that semester. And to say the truth, I was absolutely lost. So the thing is, it was, since I study computer science, you can't do just site building for a software project. There should be at least some JavaScript or something behind it. So kind of, I only found site building tutorials online, and not so much how Drupal really works. How could you create a module? How would you work with the back end? And I ended up in kind of hacking Drupal with JavaScript DOM manipulation. So I kind of ripped the fields out of Drupal and wrapped my own HTML around it, adding classes and stuff, and JavaScript and CSS. Somehow I made it working anyways, as you can see here. Actually, I like that design that time. Today I think it looks awful, so sorry for that. For example, what I did is, for example, this timetable, as you can see, you can put in some stuff, and depending on what you put in there, it will add classes via JavaScript, and you will get a colorful timetable afterwards, depending on your input. So that was the first one I did, and I kind of did not like it too much to not know how Drupal works, so I was thinking, why not do a second Drupal project, making a research on it and finding out how it works. So last semester I went to the Kurzweg in Munich and to the Drupal camp, and they kind of taught me a lot there. The Thunderport team taught me a lot, and I put it all into a blog, writing a blog about it. As you can see here, gosh, it doesn't look so cool. So I wrote something about setup. I investigated the different operating systems, how you could work on Windows, Linux, and Mac, how theming would work, how you could write your own theme. I made videos about it, so you could just follow along this one if you want to. I did some stuff on front-end design, generating such a student site, as you can see here. I will show it later, like probably a bit again. So just some small animation how you could present something with paragraphs and peer group then. So I show that here with some tutorials too. And here you can see peer groups over the different HTML elements, wrappers with your own classes. Right, so much to what I did. So what is this presentation about? So first, I will very shortly say where you could start, what you, I think, probably all do know. I do it anyways. So the second thing, as it's basic web techniques, debugging, of course, is important, like always. So I will very shortly go on that one too. However, there already have been some debugging sessions, I think, with Kind and so on. So I won't be like, I won't dig too deep in that in there, right? Then very quickly into TWIG, there were sessions about it too, so I won't stick there either, and I will show TWIG examples what you could do with just very easy, basic web techniques. Right, so where could you start? It's, as I said already, I investigated Windows, Linux and Mac. So if you use Windows, if you really use Windows locally, I would recommend the YouTube. Interesting.
Sure.
Okay. I would recommend the Aquia Web Desktop. I started with it, but I had problems. Like, Windows doesn't take it too seriously. Like, if you write camel case, uppercase, lowercase, it's like, I had problems there and with the path length. So I decided to switch over to Linux. This is actually what you see here too, and I put on it a Mac Ubuntu Surface, so to make the user interface look better. And I would recommend, why are you laughing? So I would recommend just build up the LAMP stack with Apache Master and PHP and use Composer for packet manager, but that makes it like pretty easy to set up Drupal. If you're on a Mac, there's Apache built-in natively too. However, for me, to use LAMP was just easier. So I did that one. Yeah. So next one, debugging. There actually are a lot of debugging tutorials online already. So the one I think works best for me is the one by Karen Kaur. Probably you know it already. She talks about debugging step by step and with comments and tells you exactly what you have to do to enable debugging and to like disabling cache and disable CSS JavaScript aggregation, which actually makes kind of strange things with the naming of the files and aggregating all together. So you should disable it to really kind of debug it. And of course, you have to enable TWIG debugging to like make debugging there. So what would you reach with that? Let's say you have structured content with div containers, different classes, and so on, and you would get, after enabling TWIG debugging, you would get such comments. And it's always from the less specific, from the most specific. And here it tells you where the output begins from. I will come to that in a second again. So here, for example, it comes from my own theme. And I overwrote this less specific field, HTML TWIG, which natively comes from the core, with this one, which is mine. And I created my own containers here and added some classes. Right, let's get to a, TWIG. Very, very short, just, you could use Kind, of course, which is a module and kind of shows you area-like what fields you have on that site, and you could, or you could use just a for in loop, or you could use the TWIG reference, so what you like there, and you would get with this for in loop, you would get the keys from the fields, which you can see on that side. I use paragraphs, so you have four times this paragraph. This is why it's four times there. Alright, let's get now to your live demo. This is a site I implemented. It shows coaches from a skating club in Stuttgart. This is me, by the way. I was 16 then, it's kind of old. So you have different coaches here. You can open it. As you see, it's like one coach with different fields, so I use paragraphs for it because you can structure content very cool, I think. I can show it here. So you have these different paragraphs with the coaches, and you can easily edit one. And for example, let's add a skater, call it name, and then you save it, like pretty structured, you have a good overview, and there you would see Katrin. I don't know, I wrote it wrong, but yeah. Right, so how does that look in code? So let's inspect. That's kind of pretty big. Alright, let's make it smaller. No. Alright, I do not need CSS now. That's always with the last minute. Alright, now. So, here you have the coaches, and it starts output from article, so it's a node, it's a content type, and it begins from a theme I wrote, and it's called TC theme, and here you can see the funding suggestions, so naturally it would start from the core. I'll show it here. So I set stable as my base theme, so here you go to themes, stable, templates, content, and then there is the node. So this is the article I showed just before, and this is like the default template which will be there. And I overwrote it in my own theme, because this is the theme I generated. There I have templates, blogs, trainer page, and here it is. So I just, what I did, I just copy-pasted, as you probably see. The only thing I added here is ID trainer. So I will show that here. This is the article you just saw, and here's the ID trainer. So you kind of, for paragraphs, as I use paragraphs for each item, you can see here it starts from paragraphs to kind of output just different items. So here you can see it. So for that we would go to the module paragraphs. So not in core but to the module. Let's close the core. So to modules. Then to paragraphs. What did I open? So contrib and paragraphs. There it is. Alright, templates. There you can see two default templates. So you could either use this one, copy paste again, or you just write your own, this is what I did. So there you have this paragraph, and what I use are different fields, and I just wrote my own HTML and classes around it to have this very small animation what you can see there. So you either could use the for in loop I showed just before, or you use kind to analyze, or which is more easy, just to go to structure, paragraph types, coach, manage fields. I do not need this one anymore. And here you can see the different fields, like for example, field home. You go here, and you see it, field home. So, very easy. Alright, the rest is really like that too. So, I hope you're still awake. Let's make a little quiz. Alright. I show you a site, you just take some seconds and think how this could look like. So it's again paragraphs, as you see, let's open a policeman. So it's actually, it should show your team, it's your team, so you have a policeman in your team, a Angelina, Yuli, and some different, the Truplicon. So just take some time, think about it, how could this look like? Cool, then I will show you now. team. So this is what I made out of it. I made a little game so you could play with it. And it's your team, it's kind of, because nobody looks at the team side. So it's very easy. I use the HTML canvas element, and here you will, like, it takes the image source from your team members, and here will be some information text. You can change the team member like that and score some points, and maybe we'll break some time. So, yeah, that's actually what you could get. So, Ruben, do you want to volunteer I know you want to volunteer. Please come to the front.
Do I have a choice?
No. So let's add Ruben here. I put the pictures for you because I kind of changed them a little bit.
I made a mistake. I volunteered as a tester yesterday, so she got my picture.
That was your fault. So just add yourself.
May I play the computer or?
No, play yourself. Like.
Okay. So this is me. Alternative text is still me. You added my picture, it's nice. So it's still me. Oh, and I've got some friends here. So I am a very cool team member. I think this is has to be. I'm still a very cool team member. So I will put some more text here about this soon. All right, let's do this. I assume I should click here.
Then you will add a new team member.
Okay, so I assume I should click here.
Yes.
Let's do it.
Yeah, probably you should close the one, yes.
This is what happens when you ask for volunteers.
It's okay.
Look there. It's me. I know how to fix it.
You can change the focal point. I used Thunder for it just because Thunder has some cool tools like the focal point and you do not have to care for all the modules. So, yeah.
There we go.
Yeah.
Look, I'm flying through.
Now you have to play it to win.
Okay.
So let's see how many points you will score.
Am I allowed to use the cheats I discovered yesterday?
No. He found some bugs. Yeah.
Okay.
So you can do quite a lot of crap with just a little bit of JavaScript. It's just, it's really easy to code. It's just a game object. This is how the game works, more or less. It's a little bit of buggy. I did not have enough time, so sorry for that. So, yeah, that was kind of the highlight of the session. Yay. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Alright, that's the page I showed in the video before. It really does exist. It looks like this. And it's like, again, power class, but this time I use peer group. And I would say I do not like peer group too much. I'm sorry for the one who developed it. It just takes too much time for me. I like TWIG more. It's just peer group, you have to click through all the user interface and wait till it's loaded. So I rather prefer to just quickly write some templates. It's just easier for me. Depends on your preference, of course. So this was my session. I hope you liked it. Any questions? Yes.
Yes. Can you show us a little bit how you make this game?
I can. However, I think the code is really awful, but I can show you. Yes.
See, that's the moment here. I think we can still add additional members.
So, just know a little bit more about like how you did that.
How I did that. All right. So I was following a little bit the W3 schools tutorial. However, they like kind of did not delete the obstacles. They kind of created a new and new. I deleted them after you can't see them anymore. So where you start, this is actually the function where you start from. What I do is when the DOM is loaded, so when the website is loaded, this function will be fired. So all starts here. And right, you have a game piece, which is your player, and the path to TrupleCon, this is the one that I like kind of, if you change, if you click on another image, it will adjust this path to where you click, and it will find the other image, which you saw, which the image that changes when you move. That was kind of difficult because Drupal always adds a lot of div elements around it, so I had to go parent node, and again DOM. That was kind of not so cool. But yeah, so this is my game area. As I said already, it's just an easy canvas that I generate. So here first, what I generate is a canvas element, as you can see here. Here it has the attributes player image move and player image, and the start function is the one that starts the game. Then I have a component, which is, for example, the the image you can see in the background that is moving is a component, then the player is a component, and the obstacles are components too that are created randomly. And what else? Crash with is for the obstacles, a collision that I wrote. Update game area, of course, it's always when the image moves, it will update the game area. If you do not do it, you will have like one, how do you say that? It's not deleting. So if you have, for example, a circle and it's always like this, you will have a stripe, a kind of. You know what I mean? Probably. So yeah. Right. So that's this function. Yeah. So here I ask which key you click, and I add some speed. I could have like incremented the speed. I was taught me to increment the speed if you kind of pass some time. But I was lazy, I'm sorry, I did not do it. So, yeah, reset move is if you like push the button reset move, you could play again. Move play every interval is the one that updates the game area. Yeah, what else do I have? Change element is the one for changing the image if you click on another team member. Some additional functions, right, for the first image that is there, getting it. That's the code. I'm sorry, it doesn't look the way I wanted it to look. It was just very quickly coded. So yeah, I hope this kind of answers the question a little bit. Right, that's the whole magic behind it. All right, any more questions? No?
One more. So obviously, like, this is your, you know, you said that like, this would be a really good idea for a staff page to just do something like that, you know, and I think it's like an awesome idea, you know.
Really?
Not anymore.
I was just doing some fun, actually. I implemented that game because I was thinking, come on, let's have some fun. Alright, I wanted to implement Flappy Bird, actually. But then I found out that this Flappy thing was like really difficult for me to play. So I left the project. And then they asked me whether I could hold a session here, and I was thinking, oh, why not combine it somehow, this game with Drupal? Then I was thinking, nobody watches these team sites, right? Nobody will ever look on them, so why not make it a little bit more eye-catching and gameful and, yeah, playful. Yes.
I would like to see a variation of this game for a team page, but not using a side scroller, more like an Angry Bird version, where you can throw the team members somewhere.
In a module with a schema and everything, and of course, will you pay me for it? Yes!
Cool. So I would volunteer as a tester again.
Me too.
Yeah, next session. Next room again.
Let your sprint message.
Okay, cool. Any more questions? Okay, then that's actually,
yeah.
Yes.
For your background, for how long are you coding now?
I started with very simple stuff when I was 11, so I created. Why are you laughing? I just created my HTML stuff, and it's like what you always do, go to the internet, look for some stuff, and then I explored Clitify, and I was hesitant to defend that, so I had my glittering HTML pages with videos, background music, and actually you get eye cancer from that if you look at it. But for me it was awesome. Then I started, I think, between the 10th and 11th grade with Java. I wrote the book Half is Java through in like one summer, and created my games. So I'm actually, earlier I played a lot Nintendo DS, I played all the time. And then I had the idea to do my own game. So I started with Java and it was so cool to create my own games and kind of stuck with it till today. Yeah, that's, I hope that answers the question a little bit. So maybe with 16, with Java, Visual Java, and web development like 3 years ago. Yeah, that's it. And thank you for your attention. Have a nice day and a nice drive home. Right, that's it then.